Good morning, everyone. Welcome to the first meeting of the year of the Committee on Housing, Construction, and Community Development of the New York State Senate. I'm State Senator Brian Kavanaugh, the chair of the committee. I am joined today by Senator Pam Helming, who's the ranking member. And I see we have Senator Mannion, Senator Ryan, Senator Brisport, Senator Jackson with us here in person. Did I get Senator Martucci? Forgive me. And we have a couple other members who are not, at least not yet with us in person, but we do have voting sheets from Senator Myrie, Senator Rivera, and Senator Salazar. So before we begin, let me just first of all note that the committee staff who work with us on you know, everything, all of the committee's activities, including Nairam Gasu, who's the Housing Committee Counsel, and Hallie Chu, who's the Committee Director, working out of my office, and Dan Mosher, my Legislative Director. And as well, of course, we have Nick Rangel, the Deputy Counsel, and Chris Friend on Senate Finance, who I think is also with us this morning. So we've had a very busy few years now in housing, and this year is shaping up to be no exception. We started the year with a joint hearing of the Housing Committee along with the Judiciary Committee on January 7th on Senator Salazar's legislation on good cause eviction. And we had a very robust turnout of both senators. Thank you to all the senators on this committee and the Judiciary Committee who joined us, as well as 41 witnesses who testified in person and many more that submitted testimony in writing. All of that material is available on the Senate website, all of the submitted testimony, as well as the video of that hearing. We also had the expiration on January 15th of the state's eviction moratorium. The good news is that the emergency rental assistance portal reopened to accept applications. And of course, we know that that legislation, the state legislature included very strong eviction protections that come with applying to that program. So anyone who is facing hardship related to COVID, who is a renter in the state, should be applying to that program and benefiting from the eviction protections that we put in place legislatively in the past year. We also have obviously a great deal of work coming up with respect to the budget. We've got a very robust proposal for a five-year housing capital plan that the governor has proposed that we'll be discussing and many other issues, including the fate of 421A tax exemption, and numerous other proposals to ensure that we get adequate housing. And also, I think we'll be paying a little more attention to the sustainability of the housing and the other construction that is going on in the state. So, and just one more piece of news, the budget hearing on housing will be on January 31st at 2 p.m. And those, of course, are streamed live for anybody who's listening can tune in for that as well. So without further ado, I look forward to working with all of you. It's been a very good discussion in this committee over the last few years and expect to be so again this year. But before we go to the bills, I just want to see if Senator Helming, do you have any kind of opening remarks for our new year?
Yes. Thank you, Senator Kavanaugh, and happy new year to you and to our entire committee. I look forward to working with all of you. As you mentioned, we have some tough subjects, some tough work ahead of us. But I think, although we may not always agree on policies, that there is a lot of work that we could come together and do to better the lives of so many New Yorkers. For example, you mentioned the five-year housing plan. I agree. I think that's something that we all need to get behind and we need to strongly support. That is the only way that our service providers in the state will be able to adequately plan and address the affordable housing needs. And as I have long advocated, and you've heard me state over and over again, I believe that as a housing committee, we need to do everything possible to protect our small mom and pop property owners who provide so much of the rental properties and affordable housing in our communities. They contribute greatly to the vitality of our neighborhoods and our local economy. And I truly believe that we can balance the needs of tenants and these small property owners. I just wanted to touch too on some additional areas where I think we need to be focused and we need to do more. And that's helping people live as independently as possible. It's been very disturbing to me to hear, to see the reports that I've received from PEF, and I know many of you on this call have received those reports in regard to community living for adults with developmental disabilities. Over the last couple of years, we have seen dozens and dozens of community residences either temporarily or permanently shut down. We've seen people who need all of our support being shuffled around, and there's no justification as far as I'm concerned on the state's part. So we need to do everything we can to make sure that we're supporting adults with developmental disabilities and keeping these group homes open. Also talking about special populations are our veterans. You know, I watched over the last 2 years as every single penny was cut from the budget for programs like the Warrior Salute Program in Monroe County. That really hurts people in the greater Rochester area. The Warrior Salute Program provided temporary housing for veterans who were down on their luck, who needed some assistance. And I had the opportunity, along with some of the majority members, to attend a recent veterans outreach program in Monroe County, where I was shocked to learn, absolutely shocked, that the number of beds available to veterans in Monroe County is so small. And for women veterans, women with children as well, there's no housing available. That's something that we need to address. And putting $300,000 back into the budget for the Warrior Salute Program that fills that need, they're already in existence. It's a simple thing to do. It's not much money. I wanted to touch on too, mental health housing, right? We don't have adequate mental health housing. I have received two calls now. I'm still in shock. One was about an 11-year-old girl who is stuck in the emergency room department. She has a host of mental health needs, but there isn't housing available or services available. And certainly last but not least is that personal care assistance. I'm sure so many of you are hearing from people who need to see an increase in the reimbursement rate for personal care assistance. What all of these special populations, I think I'd say they have in common is that they need our help, right? We need to be doing everything we can to help them live as independently and safely as possible. I said last but not least, but I do have one more thing. Domestic violence shelters. Whatever this committee can do as a team and also as individuals, there still remain, as far as I know, in this state, 6 counties that don't have domestic violence shelters. In 2018, I believe it was, there was $300,000 through a SAM grant that was awarded that would address domestic violence shelters in 3 counties, which I thought was, that's a great bargain, right? That money still has not moved. This is a crisis that we need to address. So again, I think on so many issues that this committee, we could work together. These aren't political issues. We need to come together and help people from across the state. So Senator Kavanaugh, thank you for the opportunity to share those thoughts. And I look forward to working with you.
Yep. And we appreciate those thoughts and your commitment to those issues. And just to note that, you know, with respect to small landlords, many of the subsidy programs that come through the capital budget are intended to address the capital needs of those buildings. And I would also note that this legislature put forth a $250 million state-funded supplement to the Emergency Rental Assistance Program in the summer. And I think we're unique in the United States in doing that. And that's to cover the rental needs, in many cases, of tenants who had arrears but left and they're no longer in the apartment. But we understand that those arrears were still payable. So we're still working on funding all of that need in the next couple months. But we have taken big steps. I would also note there is a bill on today's agenda that is intended to address the needs of veterans who might be struggling, sponsored by Senator Brooks. But with all these issues, obviously we'll continue the conversation. And I guess I should ask, I know we've been joined by Senator Boyle and also Michael Sherman of the Finance Committee staff is who handles housing for finance is also here. Any other opening comments before we get to the agenda? Okay. Hearing none, we have, if the clerk could read the first bill.
Bill 1104, sponsored by Majority Leader Stuart Cousins, an act to amend the executive law in relation to establishing and maintaining an emergency evacuation plan for individuals with disabilities.
Any questions or discussion? Okay, do you have a motion to report the bill to the floor? So moved by Senator Mannion, second by Senator Jackson. Any negative votes? The bill is reported to the floor. Next bill, please.
Bill 1603, sponsored by Senator Gennaris, an act to amend the public housing law in relation to enacting the NYCHA Utility Accountability Act.
And this we will be looking for a motion to report to finance. Any questions or discussion? Hearing none, do I have a motion to report this bill to finance? Senator Jackson, seconded by Senator Brisport. Any negative votes? Senator Helming, Senator Boyle, Senator Martucci, any AWR? The bill is reported to finance. Next bill.
Bill 1681, sponsored by Senator Bailey, an act to amend the public housing law in relation to establishing uniform waiting list priorities for domestic violence survivors applying for public housing.
Any questions or discussion? Okay, hearing none, do I have a motion to report this bill to the floor? Senator Jackson, seconded by Senator Martucci. Any negative votes? Any votes to advance without rec? Seeing none, the bill is reported to the floor. Next bill, please.
Bill 3130, sponsored by Senator Kavanaugh, an act to amend the Real Property Actions and Proceedings Law and the Real Property Tax Law in relation to requiring the court in a foreclosure action to provide notice to the former owner of the real property of the right to apply for surplus monies from the sale of such property.
With the apologies for the long description, this will be looking for a motion to refer to the Finance Committee. Any questions or discussion? Do I have a motion? Senator Helming, seconded by Senator Boyle. Any negative votes? Any AWR? The bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill 3132, sponsored by Senator Kavanaugh, an act to amend the private housing finance law in relation to establishing a New York Main Street Development Center.
Any questions or discussion? Do I have a motion to report this bill to the floor? Senator Ryan, seconded by Senator Jackson. Any negative votes? Any AWR? The bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill 3920, sponsored by Senator Sanders, an act to amend the administrative code of the City of New York in relation to providing for retroactive benefit calculation for the senior citizens rent increase exemption and disability rent increase exemption.
Any questions or discussion? Do I have a motion to report it to the floor? Moved by Senator Mannion, seconded by Senator Jackson. Any negative votes? Any AWR? The bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill 5280, sponsored by Senator Parker, an act to amend the administrative code of the City of New York in relation to continuation of senior citizen rent increase exemption benefits after a period of ineligibility due to a head of household's temporary increase in income.
Any questions or discussion? Seeing none, do I have a motion to report the bill to the floor? Senator Mannion, seconded by Senator Jackson. Any negative votes? Any AWR? The bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill 6085, sponsored by Senator Skoufis, an act to amend the real property law in relation to manufactured home parks.
Any questions or discussion? Seeing none, do I have a motion to report this bill to the floor? Senator Jackson, seconded by Senator Martucci. Any negative votes? I got Senator Helming, negative. Any AWR? The bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill 6199, sponsored by Senator Skoufis, an act to amend a real property law in relation to increases of rent in manufactured home parks.
Any questions or discussion? Do I have a motion to report this bill to the floor? Senator Jackson, seconded by Senator Mannion. Any negative votes? Any AWR? I have Senator Helming in the negative, Senator Martucci in the negative, Senator Boyle, you think?
I'm AWR, Chairman.
Sorry, forgive me. AWR for Senator Martucci.
Yeah, I'm AWR too.
Okay, AWR from Senator Boyle. And Senator Helming, you wanted to be recorded in the negative? Okay. The bill is reported. Next bill, please.
Bill 6210A, sponsored by Senator Skoufis, an act to amend executive law and the energy law in relation to requiring the updating of the State Uniform Fire Prevention and Building Code and the State Energy Conservation Construction Code on the basis of update of certain international codes.
Any questions or discussion? Do I have a motion to report this bill to the floor? Senator Mannion, seconded by Senator Brisport. Any negative votes? I got a negative from Senator Helming. Any AWR? Senator Martucci and Senator Boyle. The bill is reported. Next bill, please. I think you're muted, Hallie.
Bill 6411, sponsored by Senator Brooks, an act to amend the private housing finance law in relation to preferences under the Affordable Home Ownership Development Program for service related to disabled veterans.
We're going to be looking for a motion to report this bill to finance. Any questions or discussion? Senator Helming.
Thank you, Senator Kavanaugh. I was happy to pass this bill both in 2017 and 18 when it was put forward by Senator Ranzenhofer. It's unfortunate that it never, got signed into law. Do you anticipate this bill being a priority and being coming out on the floor for a vote?
I mean, I would like to see this bill passed. This committee actually reported it last year, and it's not an accident that we're putting it on our very first agenda of the year. We really do think that it's important that affordable homeownership opportunities be inclusive of our disabled veterans. So I will discuss with the sponsor and with the finance committee about, it'll go from here to finance committee because that's fiscal implications. And I also think it's good to be discussing this in advance of the budget so that if there's concerns about the cost, we can ensure that those are included. But again, it doesn't, on its face, it doesn't increase the net cost of that program. It's about creating a particular preference. But yeah, I'm certainly committed to it. I obviously can't speak for the two houses of the legislature or the governor about whether we'll get it signed into law, but I'll work with you and with anyone else who wants to work on it.
I appreciate that. And I think it's a great bill, provides a great opportunity for veterans. But what it does not address are those issues that veterans have that I mentioned during my opening remarks, right? The need for additional emergency housing for our veterans, temporary housing, putting in place programs like the Warrior Salute. I know in the budget that the Dwyer program is mentioned. Again, the Dwyer program is limited to 23, 27 counties. It doesn't apply in every county. So we need to look, even if it's on a regional basis, to make sure that we have temporary housing for our veterans when it's needed.
As I said up top, we'll work with you on that. We'll follow up with you on that, and we'll discuss those. And we're certainly committed to making sure that need is covered. I would also note that some of the things we're proposing are expanding the pie of resources in general for supportive housing and also for permanent housing through programs like the Housing Access Voucher Program that the majority sponsored last year, which would create much broader set of resources that can be used for veterans and also for others in need of assistance. So it'll be a conversation. We're just getting started this year, but I will follow up with you. Okay. Any further discussion on this bill? Seeing none, any negative votes? Any AWR? Bill is reported to finance. Last bill on today's agenda?
Hey, Brian.
Yes, please.
Yeah, I didn't hear a motion to move the bill in second.
Oh, forgive me. Good point. May I have a motion to report this bill to finance?
Motion.
I see moved by Senator Boyle, second by Senator Helming. Any negative votes on that motion? any AWR. And thank you to our parliament. The bill is reported to finance, and thank you to our parliamentarian, Senator Jackson.
I love it, Robert. Good catch.
I'm usually kind of a stickler for that sort of thing,
too. I just wanted to move through finance and then hit the floor and vote it out in the Assembly and Senate and signed into law.
I appreciate
it. Put in the budget.
I appreciate that somebody's paying attention.
Parliamentarian pro temp. Very good.
We're gonna make that official for the next meeting. And now, if I may, the last bill on the agenda, please.
Bill 6488, sponsored by Senator Kavanaugh. An act to amend the private housing finance law in relation to the supervision of certain limited profit housing companies.
Any questions or discussion? Seeing none, do I have a motion to report this bill to the floor? Senator Brisport. Senator Emanuel seconds. Any negative votes? Senator Helming, Senator Boyle, any AWR? Senator Martucci, the bill is reported. Thank you very much for your participation in today's meeting. And obviously, if there are any issues in housing that any of you want to discuss for this year, for future agendas or otherwise, please do reach out to me or to our staff. And thank you again to all the staff for all of your work getting ready for today's committee meeting. Have a good day.